नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अप विद अ न्यू टॉपिक व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू सेंटेंस ओनली. सेंटेंस इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स व्हिच मेक कंप्लीट सेंस एंड सेंटेंसेस आर ऑफ फोर काइंड्स. फर्स्ट इज असर्टिव, दैट इज स्टेटमेंट. सेकंड इंटरोगेटिव, क्वेश्चंस. थर्ड इंपरेटिव, दैट इज व्हिच इज ऑर्डर और अ रिक्वेस्ट. एंड फोर्थ इज एक्सक्लेमेटरी, which is showing some expressions of sorrow, relief, pain. Now, we are going to talk about the parts of a sentence. The sentence is divided into two parts, the subject and the predicate. Let's take for an example. I want a new car. Over here, subject is I and predicate is want a new car. Let's study more about it. Every complete sentence has two parts, subject and predicate. The subject is the who or what the sentence is about. The predicate tells us what the subject does. Now, let's take an example. Subject, who or what the sentence is about. The alligator eats cookies and milk. Over here, students, the alligator is the doer, or we can say that the whole sentence is dependent on this alligator only. So, alligator is the subject over here. Predicate, what does the subject is or has or does is the predicate. Same example, the alligator eats cookies and milk. The alligator was the subject and now the predicate is what the alligator is doing or has does or do. Eats cookies and milk is the predicate. Now, all the sentences are made up of two parts, the subject and the predicate. The subject is who or what the sentence is about, and the predicate tells us about the subject. Now, we are going to study about four types of sentences where the subject is placed. First of all, let's take the example of assertive sentences, that is statement. In a sentence or a statement, we can say that the subject usually comes before a verb. Ravi plays football. Maya lives in Mumbai. In both the sentences, plays and lives are the verb, and Ravi and Maya are coming before it. So we can say that in an assertive sentence, statement, or we can say that the verb is always before the subject. However, the placement of subject and predicate in a sentence may vary depending on the kinds of sentences. Let's take for interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentence, the subject comes after the verb. For example, where is James? Is the helping verb and James is coming after the verb. What are you doing? Are is the helping verb and you comes after are. So James and you are the subject and is and are the verb and they are placed before the subject. When we are having two subjects, or we can say that when we are having two verb in a sentence, we can say this thing that the subject is going to come in between the two verbs. What are you doing? You is the subject which is coming between are and doing. Have you seen my notebook? Have and seen are the two verbs and you is the subject which is coming in between them. Would you like to have some coffee? Would and like are the two verbs and you is the subject which is coming in between them. Some of the times, to find out the subject, we can rewrite it as a statement, or we can change or transform the interrogative sentence into assertive to get the real or correct answer. Likewise, is this your pencil? In this is your pencil is the statement. And this is the subject over here. Did you watch the match? You watched the match is the statement for it and you is the subject. I hope it is clear to you. Now let's move on to the imperative sentences. In imperative sentences, the subject is implied. Means we don't have a subject and we have to imply a subject. Please pass me the salt. We don't have anybody to whom we are speaking out. So the implied subject is you. Put the flowers in the vase. And you will be the implied subject over here. Let's move on to the exclamatory sentences. In exclamatory sentences, the subject comes before the verb. For example, what a beautiful picture it is. So, in this, it is the subject which is coming before the verb. Is the verb. How amazing these children are. Are is the helping verb. And these children are the sub. These children is the subject over here. Students, when we have here or there in the sentence, in these sentences with here and there, the subject comes after the verb. For example, there are many trees in the garden. So many trees is after are, and the subject is many trees. Here is the lost book. Is the helping verb and the lost book is the subject over here. Hope you have understood each and every aspect quite clearly. Once again, the naming part of the sentence is the subject. It tells who or what the sentence is about. Predicate, the telling part of the sentence is the predicate. It tells what happened. For example, the rabbit ate the carrot. Yes, the rabbit is the subject over here and ate the carrot is the predicate. Thank you for listening to me very carefully. Hope you have understood the chapter very well.